All right, later, Tachi. All right, well, that finished the first tournament. All right, we're going to do a new tournament here in just 1 second. I need to check something first. One thing up here before I do the next tournament. Where is it? That's not that bad, actually. Thank you for the follow. All right, we're getting back to this now. New tournament. Let's change the arena. We'll just do it. SmackDown. All right. There we go. First round match. How you doing, Michael Myers the Killer? Hope you're having a good day. Welcome to the chat. All right.
Rusev Udria, Rusev Machka.
Wrestler making his way to the ring.
His opponent, from Avalon, weighing in at 222 pounds, the Warlock, Yosef Zed.
Oh, just starting things off with the spine buster. Barrel spine buster, be specific. Oh, nice little spear there. Another former sumo wrestler. Another one. Oh. Sakamoto just using that. Akira is just using that incredible short burst speed that he's got from his many years of sumo wrestling. By his immense physical strength. He is much faster than he looks. Same time, Yosef Zenk is physically is physically stronger than he looks. Than you would think, I should say. He looks reasonably beefy. It's just, you know, he's in there with the 400-pound sumo wrestler. Kicks out at one. Knee lift. This sends him crashing to the floor. Ooh. Smashed him face first into the mat. Off the floor. Oof. Headbutt. Into a camel clutch of some sort, I believe. Spinning gut buster. Uh-oh. Out for the Alabama Slam. Oof. Hangs up at the top rope. Now we'll see setting up to finish the match off. Oh, counters his way out of the Kimono. Up, but... Ooh, gut buster. Series of counters there. Oh! Finishes him off. Oh. Finishes him off with the Night Queen's blessing there. Oof.
your winner, the Warlock, Yosef Zeng.
Alright, next up is Xander Voda versus Bruce Leonard. A professional monster hunter versus the self-proclaimed chosen one. Off the nice little neck breaker. Another neck breaker. A little triangle, arm in triangle there. Xander manages to roll his way through. So Xander is a physical powerhouse, you know, specializing in strikes and running maneuvers. Despite Bruce's very, very solid striking and grappling skills, he is primarily a submission specialist. So A lot of his moves are trying to set up his Dragon Sleeper, which he uses to finish most of his opponents off. Xander's plan is pretty straightforward. Just keep hitting his opponent until they go down. Very nice mission hold there, but Xander managed to fight his way out of that one too. But Leroy's working on that, working on the head and neck area of Xander pretty exclusively. Suckered Xander into coming at him and threw a little nice little kick to the head there. Flings into the corner. Drop kick to the mush. Rolls into the pin. Kicks out at one. Xander just headbutts Leroy to the ground. Ah, he's setting up for the Claymore. Bust Leroy open. Sorry, Leonard. Just remembered his last name for some reason. And just knocks him out with that brutal, brutal Claymore kick to the head. Xander gets across paths with one of his least favorite people in the world, Josef Zenk, in the next round. All right, let's see, what's next? The new guy, Eric Tolis versus Bishop Boone, Buzzsaw Bishop Boone. This is a contrast of styles and size. Eric is the largest competitor we have, and Bishop is probably the lightest of the male competitors. He's got height, but he's fairly tall. But even compared to, even though he's normally isn't tall as some a lot of the other competitors, Eric will probably tower over him.
180 pounds, Buzzsaw Bishop Boone.
Dropkick barely moved Tolos. Ooh. Clothesline knocked him off his feet, though. Just picks him up and puts him down hard. Gut-wrench powerbomb looks like coming up here. Oh, no. Gut-wrench sidewalk slam, it looks like. I don't know. Gut-wrench slam of some sort. I don't know which one. Just a big shot to the gut. Arik's moves. Arik is not the most subtle of competitors. He makes Voda look like a technician, honestly. But he has a real knack for just using that brute strength. He does have some technique in his grappling, but that's about it. And again, he's a little quicker than he looks. Fallaway slam. Ooh. Nice belly to belly there. Neckbreaker. Oof. Does not put him down with that Kinshasa. Another one, try and put him away. No! I don't think I've seen anybody take two of those to the head and actually kick out. Boone is not adverse to bending the rules if he feels the need to actually to put one over on his opponent. Ref seems to be a little dazed. Ref's focusing on working on the turnbuckle. Boone's dropping knees in the small of Arik's back over and over and over again. Goddamn it, game. Why? Why does it get in these loops? I don't get it. Series of trio of German suplexes there. Picks him up. And puts him away with the F5. Ooh. Boone hit him with two Kinshasa and did not put him away. Big man take a beating.
Here is your winner, the Anomaly, Eric Tolo.
Alright, final first round match. Barton Mercer versus Alex Van Sice. I don't think these two have crossed paths in my testing yet, thinking about it. Don't let Barton's size and build fool you. This man can move.
And his opponent from Amsterdam in the Netherlands, weighing in at 235 pounds, Valiant Alex Van Sice.
drops Barton to one knee, but and just throws him out of the ring casually. Alex is, yeah, he's pretty strong. One of those gentlemen who are, who look physically imposing and are stronger than they look. Oh, spinning sidewalk slam. Very nice. Breaker. Knocks him back to the ground with a simple chop. Brutal. Standing senton. Well, Alex gets the knees up for that one. Up on the ropes. Oh, Alex counters into a nice neck breaker. That's the fist. Barton kicks out of two. Center for the AA. Gets Barton up and down. Will that put Barton away? It will. Damn. Well, in the semifinals, it'll be Alex Van Sice versus the monster. Oh, boy. It's the anomaly, and it's Josef Zenk versus Xander Voda in the other semifinal match.
Here is your winner, Valiant Alex Van Sice.
Joseph Zenk versus Xander Voda. These two have a bit of a history in my testing so far.
And his opponent, from parts unknown, weighing in at 246 pounds, the professional Xander Voda.
See what's going to happen here. Joseph gets off to a fast start. Suplex. Punches. Oof. He's slamming him home. Again. Yeah. That's down at the moment. Oh, he's busted him open. Snapmare. Elbow to the head counter. Nice. Oof. Beautiful sidewalk slam. Beautiful Uranagi. Zenk is not happy with Voda for making him bleed his own blood, as it were. Night Queen's blessing. That gives him the victory. Josef Zenk is moving on to the finals. Despite taking some damage against Voda here, he weathered the early storm from Voda and then came back and just utterly put him away. Alright, other semi-final match. Daring Young Superhero from Amsterdam, Alex Van Zeiss versus the Undead Anomaly, Eric Tolos. Oh boy, this should be an interesting one.
opponent, from Amsterdam in the Netherlands, weighing in at 235 pounds, Valiant Alex Van Sy.
Just slams into the ground. Oof. Van Sy peppering the blows and sending them off the ropes. Walton the giant. Oh, it just takes brute force takedown there. Ooh. Double hammer fist to the back. Brutal powerbomb there. Sends him flying to the corner. Oh, a beautiful arm drag. Not sure how he got the big man over, but combination of technique and physical strength, I suppose. Snapmare to get him down off his feet after utterly failing that initial strike. Ooh, gut wrench. Suplex there, beautiful. Oh, here he goes. That patented trio of German suplexes. DDT. Swats him away. Oh, he's setting up for his... Yeah, got him up. F5. Oh, boy. And Arik Tolas just decimates last week's tournament winner. Ooh. Utterly decimates him. I mean, Alex put some good offense in there, but it just didn't seem to dent the big man. Ugh. Or big zombie, or whatever Tolas is.
Here is your winner, the Anomaly, Eric Tolos.
Oh, now the Undead Anomaly is going to be crossing past the Warlock. I know there's not much love lost between the two of them. It should be a brutal match. Into the tournament finals here. Looks like Yosef's used some restorative magics backstage after the match to
championship tournament, making his way to the ring from Avalon,
prepare himself for this battle with the Undead Anomaly.
The Warlock, Yosef. His opponent, standing 7 feet tall, weighing in at 443 pounds, the Anomaly, Eric Tolos.
Two straight punches to the head there. Atolis, but, oh, wow. Nice clothesline to take him out of the ring. Let's see. Nice counter. Sends him back into the ring. A camel clutch, trying to make the undead giant humble, but that's not happening. Just bludgeons the warlock to the ground, right to the eyes. Crossbody takes him off his feet. Yosef Zenk has been in pretty handy control over Aratolos here. Splash to the back. Rubbing his face on the ground. That might just make Arik angry, Yosef. That might not be the best plan, dude. He seems to be in control so far, so maybe he knows something I don't. Oof. Picks him up and slams him down. Drops him on the stairs. Oof. Three. Oh, power slam there. Double axe handle smash. Did the damage you wanted to do outside the ring there. Suplex. All right, puts him back up. Oh, it's that trio of Germans he likes. Setting up for that F5. Scoops him up. Drops him. F5. Is that enough to put him away? It is not. Zen kicks out after the F5, though he is looking groggy and worse for wear. Is not happy. He's pounding away on him. Up, oh, counters into an arm. Shoulder breaker there. Ooh, Uranagi. I don't know how he got the big man up for that, but. Puts him away with a Uranagi. Zenk does not look steady on his feet, but he managed the win. And thus wins the tournament. Damn. As I said, we're going to do a Fatal 4 with the women who were not in the tournament, and then we'll do an Elimination Chamber with the men. I think that'll be it for stream. Sort of my gut feeling. We'll see what time it is after that, but...
Here is your winner, the Warlock, Yosef Zed.
Fairly impressive performance tonight by Yosef Zenk in the tournament. Could be looking at a potential favorite to possibly end up capturing the title when the league goes live. We'll see. He's been doing pretty well in my testing, so. And he went through three tough opponents. Two guys, all of whom are bigger and stronger than he was. It's just